back together anymore. Right, hello, Southport, the place I call home. So, yeah, we'll clear this up right away. I am not a Fat Bono tribute act. if you don't know me, my name is James. If you do know me, still James. And I want to clear something else up as well. I do have what some years would consider a disability. Now, others would call it an impairment, but I like to call it just what it is. I'm Scottish. Some people do actually consider that a disability. It is probably because they bump into things quite a lot. But I do blame the alcohol for that. That's probably why the Scots are labelled as an aggressive nation, aren't they? Sometimes justifiably so. A few years ago, I seen a guy in a phone box in town, and he was headbutting the phone. And I thought, yeah, he's definitely Scottish. And he's definitely phoning Scotland, because that's the code. Another one of the myths about Scotland is that we don't all come from Glasgow. Which is a good thing, because a Glaswegian accent can be really aggressive. No matter what they say, something quite innocent, and it comes across as terrifying. For example, I've seen a guy collecting for a charity in town, a Glaswegian, and he was saying, excuse me, would you like to donate to the Deaf Children's Society? And I was like, how much do you want, mate? You know, if somebody says to you, deaf blood, you would, wouldn't you? a Glaswegian once asked me for directions. He said, hey, pal, could you tell me the way to the children's play area? I thought, I'd rather not know you, right? But I come from the northeast. I come from a tiny little town in the northeast of Scotland. And our accent's a lot more musical and a lot more innocent. So the opposite happens. When we see something, we say something really bizarre and outlandish, it sounds quite normal. I remember my biology teacher saying, well, children, would you like to come to the abattoir and see the lovely dead animals with our throats cut? Sounds like a nice day out to me. So, and he's saying, if you get mugged in the northeast, you'd be unlikely that you'd know it because they're so polite. Oh, I'm just going to rob you. Now, as long as you don't misbehave, I'll only stab you a wee bit. Very, very polite. But no, what I was obviously getting to is, I am blind. Shocker. What gave it away? I'm either blind or I'm having the world's biggest blink. I only mention it in case you're thinking, what a pretentious prick. Wearing sunglasses, indoors, at night. It's night time, isn't it? thank you. Glasses do have a medical purpose, yeah. I had a one-night stand with a nurse and I don't want to recognise them. But I recently had a guy come into my local and go, hey, what's with the shades, man? You think you're Stevie Wonder or something? And I thought, I can't be mistaken for Stevie Wonder, surely. I don't sing, I don't play piano, and it's pretty obvious to everybody here, I am not American. But I have been completely blind for almost 9 years. And I'm not looking for sympathy with the blind thing, not at all. Even though, in those 9 years, I have never seen my little brother. It's all right, that's not really a blind thing, he's just a prick that never visits. But I'm also hearing impaired, so it's a double whammy. But to be fair, I've only been deaf 2 years. I'm just trying that one out to see if I like it. But I do try not to let the deaf-blind thing hold me back. I still work, and I actually still volunteer for the Royal National Institute of the Blind, the RNIB. And I said this at a gig recently, and somebody shouted, oh, the lifeboats! No, man, that's the RNLI. Could you imagine if I worked for the lifeboats? You fell overboard in one of your cruises, right? You're thrashing about 50-foot waves with your high-visibility life jacket, blowing your whistle, flashing your light, and screaming for help at the top of your lungs. Trust me, I am the last person you want to look at. They're a blind guy. To be fair, I do have a heightened sense of smell. So I could probably tell you were shitting yourself when you did it. And then...